I see a plant and I think about how I can dissect it. I see a shrub and I think of how many thousands of little plants I could create from it.
Bri Gluvna is a self-described plant nerd.
Yeah, that's true. I am not well adjusted. I don't have other interests. I love plants. They are my children. They are. I live and breathe plants. It's what interests me the most. And I hope my excitement and everyone here at the nursery's excitement encourages more people. We want to see everybody have fun and have success with growing plants.
Gluvna and her colleagues at the Camellia Forest Nursery in Chapel Hill run one of the largest specialty camellia operations in the country.
There's five categories of camellias. So a single flower form is indicated by one single row of petals and clear stamens. There's a semi-double, which has more petals, but you still see the stamens. You have a formal double with many rows of petals and don't have visible stamens. The anemone form, which actually has petaloids, which cover the stamens. And then you have the peony form, which the stamens are present, but you don't see them. Of all the flower selections, formal doubles are by far the flower that appeals to the most people.
Camellia Forest Nursery grows and sells what they call a collector's market of plants.
We don't sell things that you would find in the box stores. We're more for people that are really genuinely interested in gardening and in expanding their own collection. We literally have everything from Acer to Zenobia.
Camellias occupy a unique place in the ornamental landscape, providing a burst of color at a time when everything else is dormant.
What makes a camellia special is that it blooms in the wintertime at a time when there really isn't a lot else happening in the landscape. Camellias are at their prime. Within this genera, you get to have color, if you pick the right cultivars, from September until May. It's really extraordinary.
The nursery offers over 400 different cultivars, or varieties of camellias.
Greenhouse number one are one-year-old rooted cuttings. We have sesanquas, which are fall bloomers, on one side, and japonicas, which are the winter and spring bloomers, on the other side.
The majority of cultivars at the Camellia Forest Nursery have been bred for cold tolerance.
And then they grow.
Which allow the plants to thrive in the Carolina climate.
This is a really special cultivar called Crimson Candles. It's actually bred here at the nursery by Dr. Clifford Parks. It has these amazing flower buds that form in November and just keep growing and growing all winter until they finally bloom. It's usually at its peak right about Valentine's Day. I always tell people, this is way better than a dozen roses. It's a Valentine that keeps giving.
The Crimson Candles is just one of many varieties bred by Dr. Clifford Parks.
Dr. Clifford Parks was a botany professor at UNC and a professional camellia breeder for more than 40 years.
All these new things you're learning.
In 1979, Kai May Parks started the nursery as a way to get Dr. Parks' camellia selections into the marketplace.
Now, over 30 years later, their son David Parks owns the nursery and is actually continuing the breeding and expanding the nursery. We've gone from being straight retail to retail mail order. Now we primarily use internet sales.
Kai May attributes the company's success to their efficiency and quality control.
We don't put the small plant in a large pot and sell them for more money. We move them slowly into a larger pot. And so people don't lose our plants. And they will come, our customer will come back and say, oh, I got plants from you, I've never lost anything. The plants I get from the big box, you know, like they have no survivors, you know. So that's how we grow.
While the Camellia Forest Nursery is certainly a business, for Kai May and the rest of the staff, it's clear their roots go deeper than the bottom line.
How does it make you feel when you see the blooms really start to burst?
How do you feel when you see them?
Yeah, they're beautiful.
Yeah, you see, that's it, you know. Oh, look at those! Especially when the new ones come out, they're huge flowers. I love these plants.
That infectious enthusiasm fertilizes the nursery with passion and efficiency.
You either grow it from a seed or you grow it from a cutting, but either way, you are creating something out of practically nothing.
And many of the cultivars Gluvna propagates will be used for an everyday item not often associated with camellias.
The only species that's used for tea is Camellia sinensis. When you're drinking tea, you are actually drinking the the two top leaves and a bud. This is exactly what tea is, and then it's ground and dried and then often flavored with other herbs or fruits. And that's what you're getting in those small prepackaged tea bags. Every grocery store in America has camellia in it. People don't even realize it.
Whether you are looking for medicinal or ornamental plants, camellias are a great place to start your next gardening project.
If you get them sited correctly and you can keep them watered through the summer in those first couple of years, you're bound to be successful. And I say camellias should be the crop that everybody at least tries once. But they're a very easy, low-maintenance plant. Every garden in North Carolina ought to have one. Well, they ought to have 10, but we could start with one.
Quality public television is made possible through the financial contributions of viewers like you, who invite you to join them in supporting UNC-TV.